So there's been a lot of new exciting updates and announcements in Webflow Conf, and in this video we're gonna try to see everything that's happened and what they announced. So let's look at it and see what's new for Webflow. And right in the beginning, there's a lot of talking around, but especially at the quarter hour, they talk about three key trends that they've analyzed, and I think this starts to get really interesting.
The first trend that we're going to talk about is, and you probably guessed it, AI.
The next trend we've been thinking a lot about is the growing pressure on marketers to do a lot more with less. And a third big trend we're watching relates to the process of actually building sites day to day.
And basically everything that they're announcing falls into one of these three categories: AI, collaboration, and conversion. So let's continue and see what exactly they have announced.
So today, we're introducing an all-new product navigation built to help you and your team work together while providing the same best-in-class experience, whether you're a designer, developer, marketer, admin, or agency partner.
So this struck me a little bit by surprise, but they're updating the UI once again. And like, it's a little bit in line with their making it more accessible for also for marketers. So totally understandable. And I will be excited to see how it really changed the way we work with Webflow on a daily basis. And so they also changed like this kind of styles at the top bar, which they call context ribbons. And this is also like an interesting like little visual update, but nothing too big.
We're announcing component style variants. Component style variants are a new way to bake style options right into your components.
So I think these component style variants are really, really nice. And I look forward to working with them because it makes everything much more usable and it makes the component style not so bloated. You don't have to like duplicate one component 100 times and link it again. So I think it saves a lot of hassle and I think it's a great update, to be honest. And so at this part, it gets really, really crazy.
I am so delighted to announce a new, dramatically faster way to create sections in Webflow. Introducing the Webflow AI Assistant. The AI Assistant is a brand new tool that harnesses the power of AI to help the web designers who are already great at Webflow go even faster. The Assistant has all kinds of skills you can use throughout Webflow. But when it comes to design systems, our AI Assistant can take the kind of section you asked for, give you some layout options to choose from, and then use AI to apply your existing design system to it. Let me just repeat that. It doesn't just create generic designs. Webflow's AI Assistant detects and applies your site's design system, but it does not use your data to power our models.
So when I first saw this, I was really like mind blown and thought like, damn, and now every marketer is gonna become like a Webflow developer, but because not everyone can like make stuff with prompting and there's like not a lot of like a big barrier to design, but it needs to be seen how good the design quality really is from this AI tool. And this may be a hot take, but I think it will actually produce a lot of badly designed sections or sites, because now more and more probably marketing people will use it so they can design. And yeah.
The brand new marketer role. When a teammate is assigned the marketer role, they get access to page building, a drag and drop experience in Webflow where less technical users can build brand consistent pages with that powerful design system we watched Ben set up earlier.
I think this makes a lot of sense because they're pushing more and more for this like marketing people, and I actually think it's great because they can't break anything and they can just edit like content for themselves, which can make collaboration a lot like smoother. And now what's also interesting, they said this in a side note that multiple people can edit the site simultaneously, but I think it only applies to like the editor type of role, like where you can only edit the text, but we'll see.
Absolutely.
I, on the other hand, am more of like a ukulele gal myself.
That vibe works.
But truth be told, I'm severely rhythmically challenged. Should we do a duet?
I don't think anyone wants to see a ukulele, saxophone, rhythmically challenged duet. That's just not gonna happen. So, no.
Am I the only one who finds this really cringy? I don't know. Let's continue.
So we're launching a new set of bulk CMS APIs so you can create, read, update, delete up to 100 CMS items in a single request. And those APIs, are available today.
These bulk CMS APIs could be really useful for like automated or very big sites. And I'm really excited to try this out myself and see if it's good or not. And now after this, they dropped another really big AI update feature. And now let's go take a look.
That we're adding another new skill to the AI assistant that Ben introduced earlier. And that's copywriting. We're gonna go ahead and generate a new item, and we'll use Greamer's talk title and a little description as the prompt, and then we'll generate that item. Now, I may not know, but let's see if our AI assistant knows what Greamer's talk might be about. And boom, there it is, just like magic.
And now I think personally, this could be really interesting for, especially for small businesses, which they don't have a lot of like people and they don't have a lot of content writers. And it basically lets you create content way faster, but it still needs to be seen how good the quality really is. So let's go on.
So today, I am thrilled to announce the first new addition to our website experience platform, Webflow Analyze. Webflow Analyze is a native analytics tool that gives you the visitor insights you need exactly where you need them, all with automatic, effortless setup. With Analyze, we can get an overview of a site's visitor data right inside of Webflow. This is where we can tune into how visitors are interacting with the site, like what parts of your site are getting attention and who your audiences are.
This seems really interesting because you know, don't need to fiddle around with like third-party analytics companies. And it needs to be seen how good like everything really is, how good the dashboard is and how it works. But at the first glance, it seems really interesting and a good way to like streamline everything and to streamline your site building.
In addition to the new Insights tab, you can quickly access analytics data while you work visually in the context of the page you're working on. So if we want to know how the registration CTA for FusionConf is performing, with just one click, while still in our design flow, we can see how visitors actually interact with that element.
And I think honestly, this is going to be the update that I'm most excited about because it just gives you so much more insight into every site, how they're performing. And yeah, I'm curious to see how good it is.
I am thrilled to introduce you to the next element of our website experience platform. It's called Webflow Optimize.
And so next to introduce another like set of core features that I think are really, really interesting. And they are calling it Webflow Optimize.
AI Optimize is based on proprietary predictive AI that we've been training, refining, innovating on for the better part of a decade, and it's natively integrated into Webflow. AI Optimize delivers true one-to-one personalization at scale, learning from your visitors' behavior and automatically adjusting what gets shown to whom over time. Unlike traditional A/B testing, which is just reporting on the results of a test, AI Optimize is taking action based on which variations are driving more of the conversions you care about. It automatically shows the good ones more often, so they give you a bigger benefit, and starves the poorly performing ones of traffic, so they hurt you less.
I know this seems really crazy again because they like kind of combine the element of AI with A/B testing. And I think they kind of just try to help you with all the data that it gathered to make the best version of the site, which sounds really, really exciting. And we'll need to see how good it really is.
Not only elevate the 1,300 partners in our program today, but also give new partners the tools that they need to build a better practice with Webflow. And this included a complete overhaul of the program and product experience. And for the first time, a centralized partner hub improved benefits, resources, badges, and more directly in your Webflow dashboard.
So yeah, the Webflow Partner Program has completely been overhauled, and I will make an upcoming video about that to dive deeper on all the changes. But for now, let's just continue.
And I'm happy to announce a new but familiar feature called Client Payments. We've built a brand new product that allows you to request payment information from your client while their site is built and hosted within your workspace.
Really great feature that they bring in this back, and I think client billing is a great thing to have, to not like have to transfer the sites forth and back so your client can pay. It's great.
Personalization and the ability to do it all at the individual level with AI Optimize.
Yeah, that was a lot we just talked about. I'm also so excited to start seeing all the incredible websites you'll build and hearing about all the ways our website experience platform is moving the needle for all of our customers.
And so all in all, it kind of seems like they are aiming for to become this one platform where you can do everything. For example, analyze and like build and like every aspect of website creation. So yeah, that was basically it. What I found most interesting was definitely the AI parts and the optimize and analyze parts. And yeah, let me know in the comments and thanks for watching.
So on one final note, let's get ready to build better together.
Thank you, everyone.